Isn't there a way to maybe bring them back? I didn't have the answer to that question, but I thought maybe after a few summers, I could figure that out and I'd move on to something else. And here I am 45 years later.
That's Dr. Steve Kress, also known as the Puffin Man. Puffins had nested on islands near Maine until they were extirpated by hunters in the 1800s. Steve Kress was committed to bringing these seabirds back to one island called Eastern Egg Rock, and that's how Project Puffin got started in 1973.
How do you reinsert this lost species and other highly migratory birds as well, like terns and razorbills? We had to begin thinking like a puffin. I managed to make my way to Newfoundland in 1973 and collect the first six puffin chicks. They were brought to Hog Island and eventually were released at Egg Rock. After 4 years that nothing had come back, I began realizing, well, we got potentially a problem with this project. And I began thinking, what could be missing here? Maybe they're coming back, but they're just scared to come ashore because normally there would be other puffins there. And that's when we came up with the idea of putting out some decoys. The most amazing thing happened. On a rock where we had two wooden decoys, almost immediately there was a third bird. The combination of mirrors and decoys brought more and more puffins. And so on the 4th of July in 1981, we saw it finally. A puffin came zooming in with fish in its beak, and it dropped under the rocks, and it came out shortly thereafter without the fish. That was evidence that after nearly 100 years, there was a puffin chick on Egg Rock again.
Today, Audubon Seabird Institute is using the success story to restore not just puffin colonies in Maine, but seabirds worldwide. You can learn more and take action at audubon.org/save the seabirds.